For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places.
Took the 32nd degree of Freemasonry. It says that Freemasonry's goal and aim is to rule the world.
Doing everything to absolute excess, pushing yourself to the absolute limit so you know at least where your limits are.
So I'm sure you recognize that.
Why is your hand over your eye?
Because I'm a devil worshiper. What are you talking about?
All right, well, I have tickets to see the devil worshiper.
And they had as king over them the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in Hebrew is Abaddon, but in Greek he has the name Apollyon.
Historians say Masonic connections and principles played a decisive role in the founding of the United States.
But know this, that in the last days, perilous times will come, for men will be lovers of themselves.
Now I told you about my arrogance and cockiness already. Now, the greatest artist that God has ever created is now working for him.
Lovers of money.
Money! Come on to me!
Without the airplane that we have that I bought from Tyler Perry, and I didn't pay anywhere. And Tyler's one of the greatest guys. He made that airplane so cheap for me, I couldn't help but buy it.
Boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents.
I steal cars. I steal her credit card. I ain't gonna lie. There's no reason to lie. Everybody know already. Like.
Unloving, unforgiving, slanderers, without self-control, brutal, despisers of good. Traitors, headstrong, haughty. Lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God.
Because my life has been so intimately interconnected in such a public way with the great guilts of American Puritanism.
Having a form of godliness, but denying its power.
So you make no judgment on anyone?
No, but I...
About atheists?
No, I just, you know what?
And from such people, turn away.
For many Christians, the devil is like Lord Voldemort in the Harry Potter series.
We do not speak his name.
But Scripture calls us to be not ignorant of his schemes.
I kissed a girl, but I didn't.
To, as Ephesians 5:11 proclaims, have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather expose them.
Industries. I swear I wanted to be like the Amy Grant of music.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and so I sold my soul to the devil.
Needless to say, sold my soul.
Pretending the devil is not there, meddling in our lives, is a foolish disposition.
Call me in the morning. You got it. First thing.
Bye, Larry.
Vanity. Definitely my favorite sin.
God's word commands us to expose the works of darkness. To do that, we have to know what the works of darkness are. Too much is on the line to remain ignorant, and looking away is negligent.
The boy in the bubble who never could
catch them trapped. If I could go back, I never would have rapped. I sold my soul to the devil, I'll never get it back.
In 2 Corinthians, we are told he is God of this age, having blinded the minds of unbelievers from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, himself the image of God. In Ephesians 6, we are told to put on the full armor of God, which is Paul's way of letting us know that we are in fact in a battle.
Friends, I pray, sir, you gotta repent, sir.
Right here.
You gotta repent, sir, for murdering babies.
Why?
Because it's a sin before God.
Why?
Wow.
Stinky breath.
Yeah,
why?
That's pretty evil of you, sir.
Yeah, I am.
And I hope and pray that you...
Yeah.
Well, that's what you do to babies, huh?
Yeah, I love it.
You love it, huh?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, I hope that you come to Christ, sir.
Oh, I never go to Christ.
I hope that you come to Christ,
no,
sir.
No, I don't go to Christ.
Yeah, you...
I don't listen to Christ.
You will have a darkened heart, sir.
I do have a darkened heart, yeah.
You have a darkened heart.
I do, very, very much
and
so.
And you will stand before God in judgment
yes,
day.
Yes, I will, every day.
You will stand before God in judgment
yes,
day.
Yes, I will, every day.
All of the babies that
I
you
have I love
killed.
It, I love it.
Yeah, keep tearing the babies
yeah,
apart.
Yeah, I will.
Keep tearing the babies
I
apart.
I will.
Keep tearing the babies what? Apart.
From the serpent in Eden to Christ's crucifixion for our sins, to the beast 666 of Revelation.
Which is a far cry from the $666.66 it sold for back in 1976.
The entire biblical narrative goes to great lengths to keep us informed of our adversary.
I know your father. I know your mother. I know your grandmother before you. So don't play with me, all right? Neither one of you. Get off that mic and go away from here right now, or I'll make this nation rise against you. Do you understand me? Do each and every one of you understand me? Don't play with the God that ruins this earth. Now back away.
God bless you. In the name of Jesus.
We are told that he prowls about like a roaring lion. Seeking someone to devour. In the days we are now in, we can't afford to be ignorant of the devil's devices.
You are a wicked man.
How can we reach our youth if we don't even understand his assault upon them?
The debt I owe, gotta sell my soul, cause I can't say no, no, I can't say no.
In this series, we will be looking a lot at the role entertainment plays in service to Satan. Many of the names you will be familiar with, many you will not. It does not make understanding them something we don't need to do as the body of Christ, because I can guarantee you that today's youth knows who these celebrities are and are following these people straight off of a cliff into the abyss.
All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts.
Many of us are enamored with Hollywood. The silver screen, pop musicians, rock stars, models. When we say Hollywood, we're referring to the entertainment industry at large, not solely a physical place. Is it possible that your world is pagan, just as Scripture says?
We know that we are of God, and the whole world lies under the sway of the wicked one.
Could you be deceived as to who these idols, these celebrities, really are?
Hail Satan.
Might their fame and stardom be like Christ's third temptation in the desert?
All power. All riches. All the delicious fruits of the flesh. Forever. No need to suffer. No need to die for a flawed race. No blood need be spilled at all. If only you fall down and worship me.
Might there be an agenda afoot? Yes, a conspiracy.
Conspiracy theorists have a passion for making connections. It explains everything. It simplifies everything. If an individual looks out his window and sees a world racked with tragedy, accident, unexpected events. All he has to do is take a leaf from a conspiracy theory, and suddenly everything that had seemed complex before seems simple.
Interesting speculation from secret society expert Mitch Horowitz, who often tries to paint those who see the conspiracy as mad. Mitch is seen here throwing up the sign of Osiris, an important grade sign in Aleister Crowley's Ordo Templi Orientis and in Freemasonry.
Pleased to meet you. Hope you dance by night. Fine, fine,
what's puzzling us is the nature of his game, as Jagger said in Sympathy for the Devil. Do you think Satan's messengers are going to be on the level with you?
Wasserman says the OTO and its ritual are a force for good.
Just confessing their agenda out in the open?
If someone interprets this ritual to be an example of an invocation of a dark force, they are simply mistaken. This is an invocation of the light.
Satan was a murderer and a liar from the very beginning.
When a candidate comes in through the door, he's blindfolded because symbolically he's in a state of darkness, because Masonry is all about moving from darkness into Masonic light.
Now, Carlson, how in the world could any person who really understands Christianity make a statement that I am in darkness and I need light?
Well, if you read 1 John chapter 1, it says that if you are a Christian and claim you're in darkness, it says the truth is not in you and you are living a lie.
Salza became a Mason right out of law school. Friends who were Masons told him Masonic contacts would help his legal practice.
There were many attorneys, judges, bankers who were members of the lodge, and me as a young lawyer who was looking to start my career, this would be very beneficial to me.
On a given day, he is summoned to the lodge.
They take you into a small room, and they tell you to strip down. This is where you get a little bit nervous.
Salza tells himself it's just fraternity monkey business, but his anxiety increases as the ritual continues.
They asked me to take off my crucifix and my wedding ring. If this is an organization that claims to be encouraging a man to practice his own faith and live this good life as husband and father, why are they asking me to take off my crucifix, a reminder of my faith, and my wedding ring?
Why also are they behind all of Hollywood, the spellcasting capital of the world? That's a good question as well. To explore the beginnings of Hollywood, we have to first investigate the naming of the location itself. As the ancient druids believed that the wood of a holly tree possessed magical powers, and they would use the holly wood to fashion their magical wands with. Harry Potter's wand was made of this basewood in the popular Hollywood occult propaganda franchise.
Yikes.
Today, the druids still exist, and, of course, they and other ceremonial magicians continue practicing the dark arts.
What you are looking at are actual rituals and spells being performed by practicing witches and druids throughout America and Europe.
The druid orders are full of people from all walks of life, from soap opera stars to toilet cleaners.
I, Ishtar, High Priestess and Witch, do summon and stir thee, and to witness our rites.
At the cornerstone of the Statue of Liberty in New York is this plaque from the Masonic Brotherhood, which reads, "At this site on August 5th, 1884, the cornerstone of the pedestal of the Statue of Liberty enlightening the world was laid with ceremony by William A. Brody, Grand Master of Masons in the state of New York. Grand Lodge members, representatives of the United States and French governments, Army and Navy officers, members of foreign legations, and distinguished citizens were present. This plaque is dedicated by the Masons of New York in commemoration of the 100th anniversary of that historic event." That Masonic Brotherhood created Hollywood. The U.S. has a deep history of Masonic involvement that we were never made aware of.
14 American presidents have been Masons, 5 in the last century alone.
President Truman is quoted as saying that the biggest honor that he had was to be a master of his Masonic lodge and not the president of the United States. The
United States of America, with its 13 original colonies, 13, just so we mention it, is a significant number in the Brotherhood of Satanism, was essentially founded by Freemasons. The first president, George Washington, a Freemason who even swore his very oath on a Masonic Bible.
And they will tell you that Masonry is a religion, and they claim to be the revival of the ancient mystery religions of Babylon and Persia and Egypt. And what these Babylonian cults were fertility cults.
Right.
In Freemasonry, they say that all religions are the same. It doesn't matter which religion you are. And they say Jesus, Buddha, Confucius, Muhammad, the name means little.
What did Jesus say?
Yeah.
I am the way.
Absolutely.
I am the truth. I am the light. There's no other way to the Father but by me. Peter said there's no other name under heaven by which you can be saved. How can you profess to be a Christian and turn around and buy that?
13 of the signers of the U.S. Constitution were Masons.